Honorable Prime Minister, dignitaries, distinguished guests, Madam Rehana, ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor to convey warm greetings and prayers of His Majesty the King, Her Majesty the Queen, and people of Bhutan to the government and all the friendly people of Bangladesh. It is always a delight to return to Bangladesh, which I call my second home. But this time, thank you. But this time, the reason is even more compelling. I'm here to celebrate two very special occasions. As we all know, we are celebrating the 100th birth anniversary of the father of nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, and 50th year of independence for the country that he has given his life for. I strongly believe that all of us, all human beings, and for that matter, all the nations in the world, must have a story to share. Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman has given Bangladesh a very good story to share with the global population. I'm so proud today that I get to sit next to Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina to listen to this story. I'm so proud because Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina is an inspiring leader, a mother-like figure for me. Such significant occasions uplift the spirit of not just the people of Bangladesh, but all the people in the world, especially at these times when COVID-19 has claimed numerous precious lives and disrupted the livelihood of millions of people around the world. On this note, I would like to offer my heartfelt prayers for the families who have suffered a great deal through this pandemic. We have endured the unprecedented challenges so far and wish you strength, and we hope to see the end of it very soon. I fondly recall the virtual interactions with Sheikh Hasina and the words of encouragement and support that I received from Her Excellency. And even at a distance, I could sense so much care and concern in her for the people of Bangladesh. Bangladesh is truly blessed to have her as the leader. Thank you. I'm sure Sheikh Mujibur Rahman is very proud of Bangladesh and proud of his daughter, Her Excellency Sheikh Hasina. For Bhutan, our king is leading the combat against the disease and ensuring the well-being and livelihood of our people. His Majesty has always regarded the safety and sustenance of the people of Bhutan as his sacred royal duty. With such benevolence at the Golden Throne, we feel so reassured, not just during emergencies, but at all times to come. I'm a firm believer that only those leaders who center their principles around humanity and compassion can bring about the desired peace and stability in the world. Like the rest of all Bhutanese, I remain grateful to my king. It is laudable that Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina and her team have managed the COVID-19 situation so well despite the overwhelming size and population. We are also deeply appreciative of the support extended by the government and people of Bangladesh during these extraordinary times. While we have many bilateral engagements, I have seized the opportunity to visit Bangladesh this time with sole intention to pay tribute to Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman and his historic legacies that laid strong foundations for peaceful, progressive, and prosperous Bangladesh. I've come here to pay respect to a daughter who has developed deep commitments to realize her father's dream of Sonar Bangla. Like I mentioned earlier, she is one such leader who places the freedom and happiness of her people before everything. Bangladesh has progressed at all levels. The improvements are so visible each time I visit the country. Especially in the last one decade, the strides that is made by Bangladesh in the economic front is commendable. Despite the pandemic, you have been able to retain one of the highest GDP growths in this continent. Congratulations for that. The development forecast is even more impressive. The future ahead is very bright for Bangladesh and Bangladeshis. We are proud of the progress that is being made by Bangladesh because we know that strong economy of Bangladesh will be an impetus for Bhutan and the region. This year is also very special as we have enjoyed last 50 years of bilateral relations between the two countries. As we strive to secure for more success and achievements, we will definitely be working closer at different levels in times to come. And in this journey, while in Bhutan, we are continued to be guided by the principles of gross national happiness, a development philosophy conceived by our king. I can comfortably relate that to a similar wisdom from your leader, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, who said, friendship to all and malice to none. And as I say this, I get very tempted to try my luck in Bengali, to quote this in Bengali. Shokole shate bandhuto, karu shate bidesh noy. Sheikh Mujibur Rahman thought, karu shate bidesh noy. And our kings thought, peace and harmony is the key to success. With these two identical lights shining our path, it is not surprising that the countries, two countries, have developed such affinity and affection along the way. On this note, Your Excellency, on behalf of all my delegation, I would like to thank the government and people of Bangladesh for the opportunity to be part of this historic event and for the cordial hospitality accorded to us. May the legacy of Father of the Nation echo for eternity, as beautifully inscribed by the poet Ananda Shankar Roy. Again, I get tempted to try and quote what he said in Bengali. Jotodin robe potna jamuna gori magna bohuman, totodin robe kriti tumar Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. এই কথাগুলি আমার বেশ ভালো লেগেছে। খুবই শক্তিশালীর কথা। আজকের এই কথাটা আমার মনে দারুণ নিয়ে আমি আপনাদের সবাই সকলে ধন্যবাদ জানাতে চাচ্ছি। স্পেশালি থ্যাংক ইউ ভেরি মাচ ইউর এক্সেলেন্সি প্রাইম মিনিস্টার শেখ হাসিনা, অল দ্য ডিগনিটারিস অ্যান্ড অল দ্য গেস্ট দ্যাট আর গ্যাদার্ড হিয়ার ফর গিভিং মি অ্যান্ড ভুটান দিস স্পেস to hear this true story. We remain inspired. Thank you very much.
And heartiest thank you to Honorable Prime Minister of the Royal Government of Bhutan for your valuable speech.